If you have an Amazon online store, QuickBooks is perfect for you. QuickBooks can easily be set up to be used to record transactions for an Amazon online store, and it will give you everything you need easily. This video will show anyone who has an Amazon online store what you would need in QuickBooks and how you would use it. Now, you may well ask, what happens in an Amazon online store? Well, you purchase the merchandise yourself. You arrange shipment to your storage location. You list the products for sale on your Amazon online store when you log in to your Amazon account. The customer orders a product from your online store through the Amazon site, as you well know, and then you arrange the shipping to the customer through Amazon. Then the customer pays Amazon, then Amazon releases the money to you after deducting the fees. You get a statement from Amazon explaining the amount they deposited into your account. So what do you need in QuickBooks regarding keeping books and records of your little Amazon store? Well, you need a chart of accounts that includes each item listed on the bi-monthly Amazon statement. You need all the other normal banking related features in QuickBooks, like bank or credit card registers, bank feeds, bank reconciliation, and those links are in the description. So with just the videos that are linked to in the description or in the cards in the top right of this video, you could watch those plus this and do all the record keeping and all the bookkeeping of your Amazon online store. So, what specific accounts do you need? Well, you need an account called product charges because that's the income that represents your gross sales on Amazon. That's what Amazon calls it, so you should call it the same thing so that when you look at your chart of accounts, you know what it means. Now, promo rebates is another account that you have to put, and that's a negative number. That's why I put that in red. Also, Amazon fees are deducted, and they're listed separately on the deposit. FBA fees are also deducted from the product charges from your sales. Subscription fees are deducted before they remit the payment to you. And of course, a certain cost of advertising that Amazon charges you. And then there's this thing called other. Now, there might even be more than just these items deducted from your Amazon gross sales before Amazon deposits the money into your account. The only problem is, since nobody knows what these things are, or at least none of the clients that I have any idea what they are, all they know is they have to allow Amazon to deduct these things, or they will not be able to do business with Amazon. There's one more account that you have to have in your chart of accounts, something called unavailable balance. Now, this is an asset in your chart of accounts, and it represents what Amazon keeps each time they remit money to you. So this is what a statement looks like if you took a really bad picture of a typical Amazon statement with your phone. And the reason I made the little red marks is because if I printed the statement in color, Amazon would show us the negative numbers in red and the positive numbers in black. But the most important point is to note that for every individual number listed on the Amazon statement, you need a separate and distinct account in your chart of accounts in QuickBooks to record the money amounts of those items. So, I created a brand new blank company file, and I do promise you that the only thing I have done to this file after creating the file is putting in this specific chart of accounts. These are all the accounts you need if you have an Amazon online business. You may have to add one or two expenses if your situation requires that, or if you have more than one company credit card associated with your Amazon store, or more than one bank type of account associated with your Amazon store, you might have to add some accounts, but these would be the minimum. In order to see it better, I'm going to click View and click Top Icon Bar, and then close the Home window so that we have a better view of our chart of accounts. Notice the account types that go with the account names, and it is very important that you set up unavailable balance receivable as this type, Other Current Asset. So how do you record the Amazon deposit? Well, it's very simple. You open the Make Deposits window. You enter each number on the statement one by one. You enter the negative amounts with a minus sign, and do not enter subtotals. That's it. That's all you have to remember, even if you know nothing about accounting. So if we zoom in on the top half, we have to enter previous unavailable as a positive, product charges as a positive, promo rebates as a negative, Amazon fees as a negative, the other as a positive, but the section below that discusses refunds during that period of time, so everything is the opposite. Product charges, this number goes in as a negative, this promo rebates as a positive, and so on. So let's follow the exact steps and enter all the numbers in the top half of the statement. From the main menu, click Banking, Make Deposit. Now, you have to make sure that you deposit to the account that Amazon dumped the money into, and you have to put the date that Amazon deposited the money. And you saw from the statement this was April 3rd. Now, you can leave the received column blank and just click the account. The first one on the list is the unavailable balance receivable. That's the first one. And that says 665597 as a positive number. 665597. Are there any change? Any change? 665597 is the change. So we click that. We push the point here. Good. That's a positive number. Now the next line is product charges. That's also a positive number. 13,000, by the way, remember we ignore subtotals. Product charges, 13,796.22. Product charges, 13, boy, I could never remember, 796.22. So we click 796.22. What other numbers are on this statement? What about negative 328.36 for promo and rebates? So we have promo and rebates, negative 326 point something. Let's see what. 328.36. Okay. What else is on this statement? Negative 5,364. Negative 5,364, and that was for Amazon fees. What else is on this statement? Well, we have other, which they're explaining as shipping and gift wrapping. That's $428.99 for other. $428.99, and that's for other. Okay, you have to just agree to the terms of agreement and just accept what they give. Now, ignore the subtotal. Product charges here are negative because this is the refund section. Negative 137 for product charges. Negative 137, and that's for product charges. Okay, what else is on this beloved statement? 599 as a positive number for promo rebates. So 599 for promo rebates. Oh boy. Okay. What else is on this nice Amazon statement? Positive 1559 for Amazon fees. Same as before. 1559 positive Amazon fees. Very good. What else is on this statement? Okay, other for negative 672. So negative 672. And that's the same other, because they add and subtract the same amount several times on the statement. So let's take a look at the bottom half of this statement. Subscription fees, negative $39.99. So negative $39.99. Good. Okay, so what is that? That's subscription fees, the expense we have already on the list. What else is in this statement? How about FBA fees, $138.40, negative $138.40, okay, for your FBA fees. Okay, what else is on this nice Amazon statement? $131.67 minus $131, I think that's 76, not 67, I dyslexed it there. Yeah, 76, and ignore the subtotal. Now we have other for $200.60, okay, other, oh wait, this is, excuse me, cost of advertising. So that has to be one of the expenses in your chart of accounts, okay? And then, of course, the other is $200.60. So other. Now notice in that case it's a positive $200.60. So $200.60. Good. And if you look at the part of the statement that says total balance $15,371.49, that's what they previously owed us plus the income and expense for this particular deposit. So we can see before we enter the unavailable for the current month, we can see that the total balance available here matches the deposit subtotal before we remove what's unavailable for this month. If you don't have this number, you should stop and compare all the numbers that you entered one by one to each of the numbers on the Amazon statement so that you get a total balance of $15,371.49. Now, what Amazon is telling you is that even though you're entitled to $15,371.49, they are still going to withhold $5,713.72 of this 15,000 figure. They're going to hold on to it for next time, which means the amount that they're actually going to put into your bank account on April 3rd is $9,657.77. So we have to subtract this out. Well, how do you do that? It's very simple. On the very last line, you again put unavailable balance, okay? Unavailable balance should be the first thing you put in as a positive number because that's what was withheld from last time. And it should be the last thing you put in as a negative number to make sure that your deposit equals what the statement says. 571372. 573.72. Okay. Now you can see that the deposit total, 965777, actually equals the amount that Amazon claims they put into your bank on April 3rd. And that's how you record the Amazon deposit from the statement. Very simple. Just put in the numbers exactly as shown in this video. Now, when we click Save and Close and then click Yes, we can open the profit and loss report under reports, company and financial profit and loss. And you can see the product charges are in the income section. All these expenses are in the expense section. And by the way, You could wind up with a negative expense if you got a lot of refund for a particular reason. So this other at this moment is decreasing your expenses. But it might be in the future that this account that Amazon labels other might be a negative and might be an expense to you. Again, none of my clients who have Amazon really understand what these fees and expenses are for. They only know they have to cooperate because they sign the terms and terms of agreement, and they're dependent on Amazon to make their living. But notice, the profit and loss only has the income and expense accounts. If you open the trial balance reports, accountant and taxes, trial balance, you'll get every account in the chart of account, not only the profit and loss accounts. So you can see the bank account now has, according to this file, one deposit of the amount that Amazon gave. So the trial balance will show the bank account and credit card balances, as well as the accumulated totals of the income and expense. And remember, everything else is simply using the write a checks window or the register window or the bank fees window to record any other expense that we haven't covered. So I think you have either everything you need or almost everything you need to at least start setting up QuickBooks for an Amazon online store.